This is the ministry of God's love, compassion, and mercy, taking the gospel to huge multitudes with signs, wonders, and miracles. Though based in Dubai with 19 services for a week, as founder and senior pastor of King's Revival Church International, Pastor Dil Kumar continues to bring the message of God's love around the world, receiving salvation, miracles, healings, as God comes and wipes the tears of the broken heart and fills them with life and life in abundance in Jesus' name. Miracle moments, healing, and blessing festivals in many nations draw crowds to a million to receive the love of God and be healed by His power. Miracle School for Healing and Wholeness teaches and imparts and raises God's servant as fathers to minister in the fruit and gifts of the Holy Spirit. Our Miracle Moment TV programs are seen worldwide, taking the gospel with signs, wonders, and miracles, instantly following God's word. We also run children's home for orphans, homeless kids, and take care of widows destitute in different countries. Besides these, we pioneer and oversee and support many missionary churches and nations. The books authored by Pastor Dil, such as Jesus Christ Heals You Right Now, True Anointing and Gifts of the Holy Spirit, Miracle Life in Abundance, Miracle Life Now and Forever, Your Miracle in the Kingdom of God, are available on request. Our magazine names, Signs, Wonders, and Miracles are widely circulated with credible documented healing and miracle testimonies, praise reports. Our website, www.yourmiraclelife.com. Our email, godslove@yourmiraclelife.com. Please be in touch with us for any prayer requests. He will certainly bless you and grant you the needed miracle in your life in abundance. God really loves you.
He couldn't move his shoulder, but tonight the Lord touched him and he's able to move his hand.
You can move your hand, son.
For 1 year he couldn't.
You couldn't do it, son. You couldn't do it. And now you can do it. You can move it up and down and everything. Who healed his loving son? Who healed his loving son? Everyone say Jesus.
Pastor, this is Samson. He said while he was playing, he hurt his left leg and he was limping. Now he says the pain is completely gone. Completely healed, Pastor.
You can walk now with me. No pain at all. No pain at all. No pain at all. No pain, huh? Who healed his little son? Who healed his little son? It's all Jesus.
Pastor, he had rashes and itchiness on his left finger 2 days ago. After gone. Prayer, that thing completely
gone. You're free in your hand now. All the rash, everything is gone. Who healed this dear person? Who healed this dear one? Lift your hand to Jesus. Yes, sir.
Corneal ulcers. Tonight got healed. This is the condition of his eye.
Uh-huh.
And the doctor said it was very serious, but this night, healed him.
It's gone.
That's a snap when you look at it.
Wonderful. My loving son, lift your hands to Jesus. Who healed his loving son? Who healed his loving son? Lift your hand to Jesus. Lift your hand. Benedict, Jesus sets you free now. He loves you, loves you, loves you.
Pastor, by word of knowledge, his name Benedict was called, and the Lord has filled him with great peace.
Peace, and you are Benedict. And you have received the peace from Jesus. Lift your hand to Jesus, son. Lift your hand to Jesus, who called his name and gave him that peace. He's a rewarder. He loves you, son. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you, Patricia. Jesus heals you now.
This is Patricia. The Holy Spirit called her name just now. She says for a very long time she's been having rashes on her skin. And all that has gone. The Lord has healed her.
It's all happened now, Jan. It's all happened. Rashes all gone, child. All gone now. It's all gone now. And your name is Patricia. Do you believe Jesus lives in this church? Do you believe Jesus comes in this church and manifests in this church? He loves you, child. World, you must see this. Name called out and healed instantly. It's all Jesus. He loves you, child. You will live. You will live. Your light will shine, my child. He loves you, Jane. Jesus heals you now. He loves you.
Pastor, this is Jane. Through the Holy Spirit, her name was called out. She said for over a week, severe pain on her right leg, instantly gone.
You are Jane. Oh, you are Jane, child. And over a week, you had the pain. Pastor. And it's gone. Now you can move your leg. You can do it like this. And do it like, oh my God. That's the way it has to be. Blessed girl. Oh, who called her name Jane? And Jesus healed her. Look at the joy. Look at the joy.
Pastor, this is Sophia. For over a year, she said she's been suffering with pain on her left-hand side shoulders. Pain
it's gone, child. You can move your hand. Healed. You can move your hand. It's gone, child. Who healed this dear daughter? Who healed this dear child? It's all Jesus. Everyone say Jesus.
Blood pressure, Pastor, and he had a stroke. And he had a stroke and his face was turned. Anything that he would drink, the water would fall down. And today the Lord straightened his face out.
My Lord, son.
And not only that, Pastor, he had a pain right here. Because of the stroke, his face was turned the other way around. Today, the pain that he has is gone away tonight.
Gone.
And the face has been straightened.
My Lord, son.
In the name of Jesus.
My Lord, son. Great.
This is powerful.
Look at this. Look at this, testimony.
Powerful.
Hallelujah. Lift your hands to Jesus. Lift your hands to Jesus. He loves you, son. Rejoice and live. Just come to Jesus, that's all.
What a privilege to
be. Thank you, Jesus. Come to Jesus, come to Jesus, come to Jesus. Come to Jesus.
Oh, he calls me to our care.
He loves you. He loves you. He loves you.
Everything to God in prayer.
Jesus says, rise up means stop what you are doing. Just take your hands off what you are doing. Maybe worried you are. Maybe thinking of your future. Maybe planning something. How to do this. How to come out of this problem. How to come out of this mess. How to come out of this disease and sicknesses. And my darling child. My beloved. Children in Christ Jesus. Jesus is telling you and me, rise up. That means just stop. Just it's like when you are doing your exams. When the time is up, they will just as the clock those days, my loving children. The clock, they will hit some bell and you have to just place your pens down. Just stop. And you have to rise up. Because last moment, people will be sitting and writing. So the invigilator or the supervisor of the examination says, when they hit that bell, which I have one in my room now, and stop what you are doing, put your pens down and rise up so that you can't write any further. The time is up. Exam is over. Now they will come to collect the answer papers. So this is what Jesus is telling. My loving child, you may not have written all the answers well in life. You may not have done everything good in life thus far. You may have failed. You may have missed. You may have spoiled. You, my beloved child. But Jesus is telling. He is not telling the examination is over. He is not telling that. Examination gets over only at the time of rapture. What he is telling is, you stop your writing. Whether you write 100 marks or whether you write for 50 marks, whether you write for 20 marks, that's what you got anyway. My darling children, Jesus marks you and me 100 over 100. Do you know that? Jesus has marked you and me 100 over 100. How many of you believe? That is why I preach this Bible. That is why I preach this Bible. Oh, even a sinner, 1 Timothy 1:15, is saved by his grace, his blood, his power. He has forgiven you and me. My darling child, his marks over your life and my life is 100 over 100. So he's telling you and me, daughter, my son, you just leave your pen down. But Lord, I have a lot of sins. I have done this. I have not yet done well in life. I have so much to do. Dear child, you can do it all. Just drop your pen. Lord, then what to do? The next verse is saying, stretch forth your hand. He told him to lift the hand that was physically unable. The same with the, he wants you to praise him even in the worst of your life. That is why every preacher, every man or woman of God on this earth who listen to me and watch me worldwide, we must praise him all the time. No matter what our hardship is, no matter what we are going through, he is with you in your trouble. Isaiah 43, 2, Psalm 91, 15. He will never leave you. I will go wherever you go. Who is the man who will tell us? I will go wherever you go. Joshua 1, verse 9. I will come with you. My presence will come with you, Moses. Exodus 33, 14. My mercy will go before you. Exodus 33, 19. My mercy will come behind you. Psalm 23, 6. You are in the middle, Moses. I'm with you. He is in you. He who is in you and me is greater than all. You may face the severe task in your life. Unable to face it. You may say, God, what can I do? He is your father. He is not a preacher like me. He is your father. He is going to save you. Isaiah 43, 4. You are precious in his sight. Isaiah 43, 4. Zephaniah 3, 15. Isaiah 62, 3 and 4. He is here today. He will manifest his love to you. John 14, 21. He loves you, loves you, loves you, loves you, my child. Don't measure God by the magnitude of your problem. Don't measure God by the magnitude of your problem. He is without measure. He is beyond measure. Psalm 147, 5. My great God and your great God is your Father. He only says, my daughter, my son, I am telling you, drop the pen and rise up. I have marked you 100%. He's here today. He will lead you. Oh, my God, you just told me this. He's here today. When you are in pain, when you are in agony, when you are in sorrow, when you are in difficulty, the great God that I preach, the little nothing that I am, he rends his clothes and comes to bless you and heal you and deliver you. No defeated devil can be in your life or my life. Every sickness will go. How many of you believe today? Stop what you are doing. Oh, the dear, precious, lovely doctors are nice. But don't visit them often. Visit the church and you will be healed forever. Everywhere. Don't ask people for help and money. Lift your hands and begin to praise God. When you have nothing, God will send you something from somewhere. He's a loving God. The loving Father, that little faith, that little thank you, that little praise will do it all for you and me. He told him to lift that hand. We give excuses. God, I can't even read the Bible. I can't even read the Bible. I don't feel like reading the Bible. How can I praise you, God? He told him to lift that same hand, that withered hand. Loves you. And the Bible says, immediately that hand became whole like the other hand. The moment you begin to praise him, the moment you begin to thank him, lifting hands, something happens. I don't know whether I told you. You are handing over your burdens to him and receiving the victory he won for you.
Dill Ministries International with signs, wonders, and miracles. It's bigger and faster to be connected 24/7 with the new apps, finding out the latest updates, such as Daily Life Word, Audio Gallery, Broadcast Episodes, Ministry Schedules, Praise Reports, Prayer Requests, Contact Us, and much, much more. Just simply type DMI. And remember always, God loves you forever.
It's a surrendering process. God, I'm not going to battle myself. I'm going to not struggle. I'm just going to stay put. The modern language, stay put. Drop what I'm doing. Stop what I'm doing. I'm stopping my planning now to praise you forever. That is the meaning. The whole essence of that portion is stop planning and begin praising. That's your Sabbath and my Sabbath. He said, just rise up. That means stop what you are doing. Stretch forth your hand. Begin to praise me. In that process, he is handing over his burden, his sorrow. Oh, my beloved. Oh, beloved, he is here today, Jesus. And the great Holy Spirit, you do that by faith. God, I hand over my burden, my sorrow, my difficulty, my financial inability, my sickness, my disease, my fear, my sin, my mistakes, my shortcomings, my weaknesses. God. He takes it over. He takes it over. He takes it over. Isaiah 53, verse 4 and 5. 1 Peter 2, verse 24. He is the same Jesus. Matthew 8, verse 17. He's the same Jesus. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 20. He's the same Jesus. Takes my sins away. 1 John 1, 7, 8 and 9. His blood flows. His blood flows. His blood takes my burdens away. His blood takes my sins away. His blood takes my weaknesses away. His blood, Zechariah 13, verse 1, it flows. Where the river flows, there is life. Ezekiel 47, 9, what you can't give up, what you can't give up, what you can't give up, blood will take over. Blood will wash it away. Every weakness, every sickness, every sin, every mistake. We are failures. I don't know about you, but I was until and otherwise he saved me. And now my failure passes over to success and over success until rapture. Every one of us, beloved, none of us score 100 marks in life. None of us can score 100 marks in life. None of us. It is only Jesus who marks us 100 over 100. The perfect Son of Man and Son of God. He loves you. That is why the blood, his blood takes it away and Holy Spirit brings it in. What a marvelous God. Word speaks, blood takes it away, Holy Spirit brings the victory in. Blood takes the burden, blood takes the sorrow, blood takes the sin, blood takes the curse, blood takes the failure, blood takes all the misdoings in our life. And Holy Spirit in return, in reward, in return, and it's not just a transaction, it's a reward. It's a reward when we let the blood of Jesus take it away. God rewards us through the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit takes from Jesus. John 16, verse 14, John 16, verse 15. He gives it. What does he give? The peace. The joy, the comfort, the life in abundance, the healing and wholeness, the peace, the excellence in spirit and in life, and the victory that Jesus won, my loving child. All that was ordained upon these great pastors. Oh, the righteousness of God comes into me and to you. He said, stretch forth that hand. That hand became whole. Today, now, immediately the miracle happened. No matter what you face, no matter what trials you go to, my darling children, all that the gospel tells you and me, hand it over. Hand it over. That's the meaning of lifting hands. When you lift your hands, literally you can't do anything else. You have to stop what you are doing. That is Sabbath. And do now. Let God do it for you. He has won the victory. Remember, one man won it and all men receive it. Christian life in the Bible is you and I receiving the victory that Jesus won. So you don't have to fight for victory. You receive by faith. Flesh is not willing. Mark 14, that is the fight we have. We fight the flesh of mine. Mark 14, verse 37. But the Spirit is willing. He has won the battle. Satan is defeated. Satan is defeated. Curse is defeated. 1 John 3:8, Hebrews 2:9, Hebrews 2:14 and 15, Colossians 2:13, Colossians 14 and 15, Colossians 1:13, Colossians 1:14. Oh, he is here today. By his victory we live. Psalm 92:4, the hand became whole. He was healed and made whole instantly. My darling children of Dubai and those who hear me worldwide, today, stop planning and begin praising. Oh, praise him at the worst of your life. The best will you receive in Jesus' name. He is no respecter of persons. Matthew 12:20. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He is here today. He will never let you fall. You will never be put to shame. Isaiah 54:4. It's not money, it's not wealth, it's not silver, it's not gold, it's not land, it's not property, it's not houses, it's not migration, it's not whatever that you and I think. It is the power of the Holy Spirit and the blood of Jesus. God, have my entire life. Have my entire life. Everything, God, I am full of mistakes. Wash me, that I will never do it again. Wash me, cleanse me. God, take over everything. I hand over everything, and with the same hands, I receive the victory. Holy Spirit brings us a reward. It's not an exchange. It's not a transaction as some songs sing it. Great is revelation in this part of the world, in here, in Jesus' name. It is a reward for what you release to God. It's a reward. It's not just a transaction. Who are we? We are nothing. What can we exchange with God? Nothing. We are nothing. I don't know about you. The Great One is here. I am nothing. For whatever I release unto him, he rewards me and rewards you. Luke 18, verse 29 and 30. Oh, whatever, my darling children, you will be rewarded, I will be rewarded in these years until rapture and later with real crowns in our Father's mansions. Your life is made whole. Again, I tell you, it's not money and it's not success. It's not amassing wealth. It's not silver and gold and land and property and houses and migration and this and that. No! My loving child, a life where God says, well pleased with you. This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. While on this earth, you will hear the testimony. It's not silver and gold and this and that. And oh, no, 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 my darling child. Those are all temporary, short-lived vanity. The greatest rich man ever lived on this earth, Solomon the king, said it is vanity. But the blood of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit with the word makes you and me whole, blessed, victory, excellence, peace, righteousness, faith, until rapture and eternal in our Father's mansion.
I'm going to pray with you right now. Loving Father, I humble myself before your people, and you, my God, my Father. To you we come in the name of Jesus Christ, thy only begotten Son, whom you raised from the dead and today made him sit at your right hand side, Father. And in Jesus' name, all power in heaven and earth and over the defeated hell is given. Loving Father, I don't come on my own merit. I have no merit, God. Only the blood of Jesus Christ. Only the blood of Jesus Christ. I come to you. I humbly ask you, let all the sicknesses go away. Let all the physical ailments go away. Even the defeated symptoms and the causes of the diseases go away. Jesus, let the blind see now, God. Jesus, let the deaf hear now, God. Jesus, let the dumb speak now, God. Jesus, let the lame rise now and walk, God. Even let the dead rise now, God. Jesus, with you all things are possible. wipe the tears of anyone, God. I thank you. I have told them that you will wipe their tears today. Loving Lord, Hebrews 5 verse 7, Luke 7 verse 13, wipe the tears of everyone, God. Isaiah 25 verse 8, wipe the tears of everyone, my Father. Heal all their diseases, Lord Jesus. Remove every burden of their life, Lord. Let them all rise up, walk, live, rejoice, and praise you and thank you and always give you the glory. I thank you for this, Father. I thank you for this, Lord Jesus. I thank you for this, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, Father. Amen, 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 amen. Jesus loves you. And my books are there. Jesus Christ Heals Even Now. Jesus Christ Heals Even Now, my book. My latest book on rapture. My beloved people, everyone washed by the blood of Jesus. Everyone who loves Jesus is going to be taken up in midair very soon. We are going to be raptured as we live on this earth in these coming long years. We are going to go into our Father's mansions. He's going to come in midair to take us, rapture us. My latest book on rapture, don't miss that. And my powerful book, Because Jesus Lives, You Will Live Also. Because Jesus Lives, You Will Live Also. And then Streams of Miracle Life, Streams of Miracle Life. Get these books, my magazines. Every 3 months we put out magazines, Signs, Wonders and Miracles. Every 3 months we send them internationally, and it's full of credible documented evidences of God's instant miracle healing works. Testimonies, praise reports in our magazines. You can send your request. We'll get it across to you. Signs, Wonders and Miracles magazines. All our miracles, it's increasing. John 14, 12, greater works now until rapture. It's increasing, it's increasing. We will send you our magazines, Signs, Wonders and Miracles. Send us your prayer requests. Send us your requests. We will pray with tears. And you will receive your miracle. We love you, and more than us, Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you, and you can watch us on various television channels as well. Jesus loves you. See you again, and Jesus loves you.